in some areas, 40% of the rural population have moved. They've been forced to move. With that, agricultural production has done it. In some areas, you will see one cow, all the heads of cattle have either been rustled or they've moved down south. That is part of the problem we are seeing in the area. It is a national calamity. It's a national calamity. People tend to see it in isolation. When I give my presentation, you see what is happening in the state is not diverse from what is happening here, and vice versa. So it's a serious problem. In fact, I didn't know that another northeast is being enacted in northwest. What you read about Boko Haram in the northeast, horrible things they've done in that place is also happening in the northwest, especially in San Francisco. We've gone there. In one day, there's a town, Bergaladi, in one day, 130 people. We went to that town. It's literally like a ghost town. People are hiding when they see them. When they see
them. These towns can be said to be dangerous. How did you manage to come across?
Well, we are researchers. We have to devise means of doing so. If you are in search of the truth, for the truth, you have to devise means of doing so. We will not sit down and allow people to give us a giant story. We want to understand what is happening. As the coordinator said, you know, policy should be based on evidence.
Okay, sir. I've been privileged to, you know, go to some of these communities. In other climes, in Israel, for instance, have you said Israel before? You know, the way they rear cattle and all of that, can we take a cue? What's the solution to we not having this?
There are so many. So first of all, you have to understand the root causes of this problem. Remote causes and immediate causes. Everybody saw in Israel has been determined by the history and circumstances. We have our own history and circumstances. Our policy makers are not taking that into consideration, especially on this interest. Take the case of San Francisco. If you drive from the south to the south, it used to have to be a thick forest, 120 kilometers of thick forest. This forest was a grazing reserve. What the colonial administration did by creating grazing reserves was not what people think. That they just identify space and say, you, Fulani, you take this. They identified where there were the concentration of Fulani and designate that area as their grazing reserve. And they are there since the 15th century. Some of them didn't even move down south because the place is rich. Those who have power in that state decided to destroy the forest and allocate land, you know, to the nouveau riche, what I call those bureaucratic capital in that area. And I understand we're told at the state executive council meeting, even the governor himself said, what do we do with the Fulani settlements in the forest? Somebody said, what? Land belongs to the state. Land belongs to the state. The state can do as it wishes for the state, for the land. So let them also apply for land like any other person. If it happens in the southwest or southeast or south, people will say people are being moved from their ancestral home. But here nobody talks about their ancestral home. They have been there since the 15th century. The records are there for people to see. So it was destroyed. And when you do that, you create conflict. Because big farms emerge in those areas. I'm not opposed to people having farms. If you are doing things like this, you have to do it rationally. You have to do it rationally. You can't just ignore those who are there. You get it. And so they started, they had their farms. When you drive there, you know those who have the farms are those, the movers, as Nigerians would say, the movers and shakers in that society. So pushed, it's a resource capture. The political science, there's a concept of resource capture. This is what actually happened there. So when you get closer to those settlements, or you move the settlement, you are laying the basis of the conflict. You are taking over the grazing lands. You are taking over the brutally, the cutting part. You know, you are taking farms closer to them. It's a matter of time. You know, they will encroach, on the farms, the same way the farms have encroached on their land in this crisis. That is one. I'll give you just one example. And when they encroach on the land, you get the compensation, I mean the fines imposed on them are not disproportional to what they've done. In the process, some of them were losing their cattle, and also without their identity. You get it? So they and the cattle and the heads of cattle are intricately related. If you remove that from them, you know, you are actually changing, and brutally, for that matter, changing their own identity. So those who used to have cattle became herders of those who didn't have before. So they started questioning, what is happening? I used to own it. They've used all sorts of means to take it away from me. Now I'm their neighbor. I'm taking care of their country. So it creates confusion. I mean, conflict. This kind of thing creates conflict. There are many other factors as we show when we give our own presentation.